is TCP segment. Okay, so trying to give message boundaries and telling what is the length of the segment, they are completely different. Okay, anyway, we will talk about segment here. We will try to see what is the format we have and how segment is encapsulated. So this is the TCP segment we have. You are going to have header and you are going to have data. So this header is going to have all these fields: source port address, destination port address. Both of these things, they are going to consume 16 bits. 16-bit port address, which talks about what is the port address at the source side. Okay, similar to how we considered source IP address and destination IP address, we are going to have source port address and destination port address. So what is the process to which I have to send the data, that is given by destination port address? What is the process from where I am coming, that is defined by source port address? Sequence number, that is of 32 bits, as we have seen in the previous video. It says you are going to have this data, right? For this data, whatever the first byte we have, that byte number we are going to consider in sequence number. And in case if you are providing acknowledgement number, you are going to say what is the next expected byte. Next expected byte. For example, you have set till 1000 bytes, you are going to have acknowledgement number 1001. Then header length. You have options field here, right? So we are not sure how much, what will be the size of options. So in order to have that information, we are using this header length. Header length, like we are representing in 4 bits. Okay, so this is 4 bytes. Total how many bytes? 20 bytes, right? So 20 bytes of fixed value. Okay, in TCP header we have fixed fields of 20 bytes, and these options, it is variable. What can be the size of these options? Can anyone tell? We already discussed IP header, right? By having that particular concept, can you say what can be the size of options over here? For example, if I have header length value as 8, what is the total header length? Yes? You people remember IP header or not?
Oh, yes. We had multiplied by 5, sir.
Multiplied by?
5 or 4? 4.
Okay. So basically, in IP datagram, if you remember, we had from 20 bytes to 60 bytes. And we said, like, if the value is 60, I cannot represent it 4 bits. So what we are doing? We are dividing by 4. So I'll get 15. If the value is 20, I am dividing by 4, the value is 5. Okay, so this value of header length, it will be there from 5 to 15. But whatever the value I have, I need to multiply with 4 so that I will get what is the length of header. Okay, if I have the value 8 into 4, 32, that means 32 bytes of header I have. In that 20 bytes, it is going to be fixed. So 12 bytes of options field I have, like that we need to calculate. Okay, so that is the importance of this header length. Then reserved, these 6 bits are reserved for future purpose, as of now we are not using. Then URG stands for urgent pointer. If I have any urgent information to be delivered to destination process, I am going to enable this particular flag. Okay, all these are flags. Okay, flag fields we call this urgent flag if it is enabled or if the value is set. Then whenever the data is read, okay, this TCP process immediately looks at this urgent pointer. This pointer says where exactly I have urgent information. Okay, so for example, I am sending some data. Okay, after sending, I realized at this particular portion, like I have some information, urgent information to be delivered to TCP process at the destination. Then I will enable this and I give the address of this particular location in urgent pointer. Okay, that is urgent pointer. Then we have acknowledgement. Then acknowledgement number, it's like if this particular field we are using acknowledgement number, then I am going to keep the value as 1 here. Okay, so there are some chances. So it is like, okay, let me say here, I may be sending just data, I may be sending data plus acknowledgement. Okay, I may be sending some control information like SYN message, or I may be sending this control message plus acknowledgement. Okay, it all depends. Okay, I may be sending some finish to close connection, I may be sending like this, or I may also be sending FIN plus acknowledgement. Okay, so within your segment, if you are sending acknowledgement, then I am going to enable this particular acknowledgement field and I will have some value in this particular field. If I do not have acknowledgement flag enabled, then that particular acknowledgement number will not be there. Then push data. Okay, so what happens, if I consider an example, you have some 10,000 locations in an array and 10,000 numbers you are sending to a server and you are asking the server to arrange them in ascending order. Okay, you are sending the data one by one, you are keeping on sending. Suddenly you have realized that whatever the data I have sent, these 10,000 numbers, that is not correct. Okay, and after realizing, if I say that destination process, like I have sent data incorrectly, I am sending new data again, by that time it would have processed all the 10,000 bytes of data. Okay, so in order to overcome such situations, what TCP is doing is, it is enabling a particular thing called as push flag. What does it do is, whenever I have some importance like this, I am going to enable this flag and I am going to give some data, some information I will be giving. TCP, whenever looks at this particular thing, it has to push this particular data without following any sequence. Okay, that means this particular data has to be processed before it can process remaining data whenever push flag is enabled. Okay, so that is the importance of push flag. But in the implementation of TCP, it is up to the receiver whether to consider this push flag or not. That means even though this particular field is set to 1, it is up to the destination whether to push that one or follow the actual sequence. Then RST, for example, you have experienced some error or there is some problem with the connection or if there are any issues with the network, then you will have to reset the connection. Okay, then we will be setting this particular field as 1 and we will be sending to the other entity. Whenever we want to establish a connection, then we will be keeping this SYN flag, SYN flag, which indicates this particular segment is synchronization message. Okay, and if you want to terminate the connection, you want to indicate that, then it is indicated by FIN, finish. Okay, so that flag will be enabled. Window size, we said we are going to have buffer set source and receiver, right? So what is the size of buffer we have, that is indicated by window size. Okay, directly we are not considering the buffer size available at the other side. We are going to consider some other value also in coming up with window size. Okay, we will discuss that one later when we consider congestion control and flow control. Okay, so basically you can just imagine like window size says how much data we can send without waiting for acknowledgement. Okay, if the window size is 1000, I can send 1000 bytes of data without waiting. Okay, then checksum. This is of 16 bit, same as how we are calculating in UDP, in TCP also we are calculating checksum. We talked about this urgent pointers and these options and padding. We may be having some options like which cater to the needs of something, like whatever the information we are providing in header, if that is not sufficient, then we may be in need of going to options. Then if the options are not terminating on 32 bit boundary, then we will also be going to padding. Okay, so that is the entire detail about TCP segment. Okay, so this is about the flags we have, our control fields. Urgent, it indicates urgent pointer. Acknowledgement, acknowledgement is valid. Push, request for push. Okay, without following the line. Reset the connection. Synchronize the sequence number, that is the initial message we will be sending. Finish, that is for terminating the connection. So the same thing is described over here. Pseudo header is also added to TCPA. Okay, same like how we had pseudo header for UDP, the same way we also have pseudo header for TCP. Okay, we discussed why we are going with pseudo header. Like some applications, they may require IP address to be utilized. In such cases, we cannot contact network layer again. Okay. To cater to their needs, we are having this pseudo header, which talks about what are the protocols, like what are the protocol, internet protocol addresses we have for source and destination, that we are going to mention here, and what type of protocol we are using, that is also we are mentioning here. The inclusion of checksum in TCP is mandatory because we want to provide error-free data, right? Okay. So the encapsulation is like this. You are going to have TCP segment that is encapsulated within IP packet by attaching IP header, and that is encapsulated in data link by attaching frame header. Okay, you are going to have TCP segment for the network layer by attaching header you will come, and again you are going to get by attaching frame header. Okay, the like that it appears as if we are doing some encapsulation. Decapsulation side, remove this frame header and give to network layer, remove IP header and give it to transport layer. Okay, is it clear, the TCP segment part, or any doubts you have?
Clear, sir.
Yeah. So if you look at here, do we have any length over here for total data? Like in the case of UDP, we had length, which talks about what is the size we have including header, right? When we consider TCP, we do not have. So we do not know what is the size of this particular data. The only thing we have information is sequence number. Okay. So using this sequence number, I'll have some data next. Like for example, if I receive till 1000 bytes, that means the first byte had 1000 bytes. Okay, 1001 byte will come in next segment. Like that we are going to have relationship, but we are not preserving message boundaries. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, 38, I hope the point is clear now.
Yes, sir.